Hello guys, Dan here, welcome back to the channel. In today's video I will show you how to paint Kriza Borac unit for the Nomads from Tunguska. This will be a pretty straight paint job. I will mostly use contrast paints and I will do the highlights with the regular paints. So without further ado, grab yourself some hot drink and enjoy the rest of the video. Model is primed with Redbone spray. When you do this, you need to try to get an even coat all around and try to cover the whole area so you don't see any metal under it. And then I will use a black Templar contrast color and I will paint the whole his metal plates for the armor and his gun. It's actually a very large area of this model and I will do this with two very thick coats. So I will apply the first thick coat and then I will leave a model for like 5 to 10 minutes to properly dry, and then I will apply a second thick coat over it because I want my black to be really darker. If you do only one coat, it will be like a grayish black. So this is the level of the black, of the darkness that I wanted to achieve on this model. The second color we will apply will be a Blood Angels red. Sorry I didn't show you this paint job from beginning here, because I lost the first I think 1 minute of this footage, but anyway you can see what's happening here. So you just go with the one thick coat and you paint all this little under armor that he have with the red, and as well I painted the helmet with this color. We will move now to his hair, and same as with the colors before, it's Talasar blue contrast paint, and as before I use it one very thick coat. Just try to be as neat as possible so you don't go around on the black parts or the white parts that we still need to paint. For the magazine, we'll use a Space Wolves Grey contrast. Just don't apply it in a very thick coat. So just apply it once and then clean your brush and then clear all the pooling. I like my clip to be a different color than the rest of the gun, so this will create like a little contrast in the complete paint job. For all the white parts, we will apply one thick coat of Apothecary white contrast paint. Here is important to try not to go over the black panels because this color is like gray bluish and it will create a really nasty stains over your black, so then you will have to go back and repaint the black after, so try to be as much careful as you can. And at this stage I didn't like the top of his backpack, jetpack to be white, so I just repainted them with the Blood Angels red and I painted them red just to create another level of contrast on this model. And last contrast color that we will use today will be a Crit Camo, and we will use this to paint this ammo box that he is standing on. So as before, apply it in one very thick coat and just leave the whole model after this for some time so the all the colors dry properly and settle down. Like 20 minutes to half an hour will be enough. This is how the model looks when it's dried. So as you see, it's already start looking decent, but now we will bring it to another level. We will start highlighting the model. My first highlight I will apply on the black parts, and I will use Fenerician gray. I like to do like the longest highlight first, because this will take most of the time highlighting this model. At this stage, we need to highlight every sharp edge or every line on his armor panels that he have with this color. So I suggest you to use the side of your brush or the tip of your brush and just go around and draw a little lines everywhere you can. So wherever you see that this model have a sharp edge, you draw a nice and thin line and try to follow all the contours of the armor, because this stage is the most important and it will make your model look great. So try to highlight all of these armor panels. This is a completed stage of the Fenerisian Grey highlights. So as you can see, it already gave a really nice shape to the model and really good contrast between dark parts of the guns and the highlights. So now we will proceed to highlighting the red parts. For the first step, we will use Evil Sun Scarlet. And we will reinforce only the metal armor panels. The one on his under armor that looks like honeycombs, don't touch them, just leave them at this stage. Use this color only on the, like, his boots, his knee pads, the tanks on the back of his jetpack. And as well with this, I will do little highlights on his underknees, just to create the art that was on the box. So I will just use the side of my brush. I will try to make a little like angle from like 45 to 90 degree and just try to pull a really thin lines just to create like a nice highlight there. For the final highlight on the red, we will use the Fire Dragon Bright, and we will highlight only the most extreme edges on his armor, just like little corners, the little top areas. You will highlight everything here, so you will even go on these little honeycombs that he have on his under armor. But when you start highlighting them, you just make little dots on each one of them. If you want, you can dry brush it, it depends to you. But I prefer that I highlight every single one of them. And I had some spare time, so I was just going around and highlighting only the most raised honeycombs among all of them. So I pick up the most raised ones and just make a little dots on top of them. For all the lighting, we use the Temple Guard Blue, and I put it on my wet palette. I added one or two drops of water, so it flows good from my brush because it was very thick in the bottle. And then I start painting these little lights, but trying to leave all the recesses in the shade. So just try to create a little lighter light, but not cover the whole area of it. And then I painted before the lights on his shoulder plate red, but I didn't like it because it looked too dark. Then I decided to just to paint them with this blue to create the contrast on his shoulder plate. Then I moved to do his hair, the dreads. I used the Celestra Grey, and I have to say that this color is quite bad and it's really transparent, and it loves to go really chalky, so it requires a lot of work and the patience. So if you have any substitute for this paint, please use it, or something alternative. But I use this one because I already put it on my wet palette and I already add the water and make it to flow consistently. So I will go around the hair and just highlight the most raised part, while leaving the recess is still blue. So the hair will look like really like a grayish with the blue tint, and it's a really nice effect at the end. And the next step of the highlight will be to highlight all the white parts. I used the Ultuan Gray for this stage and just went around the model and painted in two or three very thin coats all the white parts. Because this color doesn't have a really good coverage, so when you apply the first coat, wait for it to properly dry and then see do you need to apply the second one or do you need to apply the third one, because it's really transparent and you want to have an even coat all around. Just don't go into the recesses that we done previously with the Apothecary White, so just leave all the recesses and all those little lines in the shadows and highlight the raised areas of these panels. Now it's time to draw a hazard stripes on his knuckles. So I will use Averland Sunset and I will use my smallest brush. I will try to fix my both hands on the table, like both elbows fixed on the table so that my hands are not shaking and they're still. And I will just draw on one knuckle I draw three diagonal lines and on the bigger one I draw four of them. So just pick up one angle and just try to draw all of them in the same angle and try to achieve the same thickness. And to highlight those little lines, we will use Aerial Yellow and just try to make a very little highlights just in the middle and on the edges. You can use black if those lines are too thick and just go in the middle of the lines and just repair them and make them thinner. It's very easy to go back and forth with these two colors here and just make them all equal. And I used this stage as well just to paint the logo on the ammo crate that he's standing. To highlight the crate, I used a little of Averland Sunset and just did a little edge highlight on couple of the edges. I didn't want to do too many of them, so I don't draw attention to that crate from the model. So just you want some subtle highlight just to be there. And for the last finishing touches on the logo, I just used a little of Ultuan Gray. And to finish off the base, I used the Martian Iron Crust, it's a GW technical paint, and I just applied it in a one thick coat and spread it evenly around the base. So just take your modeling tool and try to spray it evenly, and then I left it outside to dry for a couple of hours. And I transferred the model after everything was dry, and that's it, this paint job is done. I have to say this model was amazing, the miniature literally painted itself. The details were so nice to paint with the contrast paints, so you don't waste too much time on the other details. Oh guys, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel, it will help this channel grow in the future. And if you have any comments or suggestions, please make a comment below and I will try to do my best. That's it for now, guys. Stay safe, take care, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.